Welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman, and today we're doing some GDevelop. Let me open the program. This is the project I'm working on right now. Let me just preview this. It's actually quite simple. It's just Sparkman jamming, and I made this tile map in a couple of seconds in the Adobe Photoshop. Now, from the last tutorial, I got a couple of messages about not being able to import tile maps into GDevelop, and let me show you what happens. Okay, so let me just open the Photoshop. So let's open the tile set. I made this a couple of minutes ago. It looks terrible, but just bear with me. So let me change the color of this. I'm going to change it to anything. So I'm gonna save this. Call this at 100. Save it, and let's replace this tile map. Let me see. Let's import it. I'm going to select the tile map, and let's select it. And you are going to get this error message: ICCP unknown incorrect sRGB profile. And you're like, what in the world is that? Okay, if you Google that, you're going to get nothing. Yeah, so that's what we're going to do today. We're going to fix this problem, and actually, it's not broken. It's just the wrong color profile. Let's go to Adobe Photoshop. Why is this on CMYK? Let's change that to RGB. All right. Even if you change it to RGB, let me just save it again. Delete this here, and let's import it again. And it gives me the same error message: unknown sRGB profile. That's super easy to fix. All you have to do is go to Edit, and let's go to Convert to Profile. So I'm going to switch this to, let's see, where is it? sRGB IE C61966-21. Let's go OK. Now this time we're not going to go File Save, we're going to go Save for Web. And that's because this reduces the file size a lot. Alright, let's switch this to PNG24. Make sure that Convert to sRGB is on. Alright. Now the preview guide said to use document profile. So let's save this, and let's overwrite this one. Let me delete this here. And let's import a new image. Here it is. Let's select the image, 79x79. And let's try it out. We can edit this now. You can edit maps super quick like this. Let's close it. Let me run this example. And you can see that it works fine. Now, if you want to draw tiles, there is always free tiles. Let me see. Where's that? Tile sets. Okay, tile sets. All right. Free tile sets. Okay, so here is a good one. Let's try this one here. GameR2D.com. I've seen this one before. I think they have more. Now they got a bunch of tile sets, and those are not free. They're like $11 each. Some are $15, but they have free ones on the freebies. Let's see, they got Santa, Cute Girl. For Sparkman, I think it's best if we download this one here. It's called Sci-Fi. Let's open the tile set. PNG tiles. Okay, so let's piece them together in the Photoshop. Okay, so I'm gonna make a grid first. Let me go Control R to bring out my ruler. And let's make a grid so we can set our tile maps. Let's bring the acid. It's gonna be here. That's the acid. More chemicals. Let's see, which ones do I actually need? Maybe you should set this to automatic instead. So we got room for one more. Let's do the spikes. Let me just close this bunch of files here. Okay, so let's save this for the web. And we're going to do the same thing. Convert to sRGB. And let's call this blocks 200. There we go. Let's edit the map. I'm going to first import the new map. And here it is. Yeah, let's try it out. For the back, we're gonna use these boxes, a lot of these boxes. and take out the spikes from everywhere. We didn't get to use the lava. Let's see, let's use the lava somehow. This is a very small map, should have made it bigger. There's a lava there. Alright, so let's run this to see what it looks like. Whoa! That is so simple. Okay, so there you go. That's an easy way to edit your levels using tile maps. Alright guys, don't forget GDevelop is free and I'm using free assets. Wow. Okay guys, if making games is your thing, make sure you hit that subscribe button. I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.